Our journey begins with my museum, a small town museum in the central part of the North Bulgaria. We are specialized in traditional crafts, so our museum is unique for our country. It was created in 1962, and the museum opens doors 6 years later. We present in details the traditional crafts, typical not only for our area, but also for all the Bulgarian lands. What you can see during this short tour through our house. So the first one is the model of the marketplace, because our town was burnt down during the Ottoman Bulgarian war, during the Bulgarian liberation. So this here is the only place where you can see how our main street looked like in the past. Of course, the heart of our museum is the pottery collection from the ancient times, during the Middle Ages, and after then the period of the Bulgarian revival, and all we have after the Bulgarian liberation. Very interesting for the visitors is this authentic pottery workshop from the 19th century. We have and another reconstructions of workshops in the permanent exhibition. And what we are trying to do is to explain everything about the development of crafts, the instruments, the traditional decorations, and everything that can be displayed as traditional for this part of Bulgaria. Of course, we try also to tell interesting stories about some of the objects, as this plate. What it is interesting here, it is that the craftsman left here his name. You cannot read it, it is Slavic, but you can see the Christian cross and four letters. This is the name Duli, typical for this area from the 19th century. Our second floor is dedicated to another crafts. Woodworking is presented in one room. We have here also blacksmith, coppersmith, smelting, and goldsmith into a metalworking section. We are trying to present all the things from the past, especially archaeological objects. And we talk with some people here from Scotland. I remember one conversation with Beverly you know, and it is the same by us, the National Historical Museum collects almost all the Thracian treasures, all the gold from our lands, but it is more value when you can see this object just in this area where it was found, and to hear this small story, but in this ground, so to be able to get connection with the local history. The four costumes present our past and what was the daily quote of our grandmothers and grandfathers. And we have a reconstruction of a house because for us it is important, the new generation, to know about this, how our grandparents lived in the past. Sometimes this place alives through different exhibitions, activities. Sometimes we call old grannies to show something, some traditional skills, and it is not all the time so empty. So one of the most important questions for us is how to attract young people, how to explain the technology in the crafts. I can tell that our museum is modern and we work well. This is our platform called Augmented Reality. So when you visit the museum, you can use your tablet or smartphone and go through the rooms watching different small short videos about so how it was made. Pottery, woodworking, metalworking. We have a very big archive with videos of old Bulgarian craftsmen. And this one here presents the making of jug for water. We have this mobile platform for 2 years, and I can say that it is especially good for children groups. We can keep their attention longer, and it is much easier for us to explain some things. I believe it is also interesting for visitors from other lands and also for the adults in Bulgaria. So when we have groups, these videos we project with the help of one smartphone, so they don't need to use many telephones at the same time. It is really something that it's not much as price, so we didn't give a lot of money to do this, only with a small money and a very big enthusiasm. So it is ready now. Last year we made also a small place, we call it a place for intellectual and social communication. This is a place where so not only people blind, but also children, students and other people can touch some from the objects. Of course, our Bulgarian wall doesn't allow to use exhibits from the storage of the museum. So we buy these jugs and things from our temporary craftsmen. And we created this place so to be able just to touch, to feel something real. Our place for temporary exhibitions is small, but we try to present different exhibitions. We change this 4-5 times a year. Last year we made a very interesting exhibition about one private ethnographic collection. So the main purpose of this exhibitions is to make the local people come into the museum. Because by us this is a real problem. Of course, these exhibitions are free. We have no entrance tax for this, and the local community and of course visitors from other places can watch the opening of the exhibition and the exhibits. This was really impressive, and I believe this is one of the we don't have many private collections in Bulgaria. And our activity, the most important activity, I believe, is Night at the Museum. It is also free for all the people who want to participate. You can see here the happy face of one young lady who decorated small plate. Of course, we have work with clay because well, this activity is only we offer it sometimes. We cannot, for unfortunately, do this all every day. And this was very interesting. Me and my colleagues tried to present the natural products for becoming so of covering wool. You can see the results. I am very proud with this because we did it actually. And I can say that it was very interesting. We had all night visitors who asked about the recipes and how can we became the yellow or the green or red. It was lucky for me to participate into this wonderful project in Scotland 6 years ago and to visit and to know more about this wonderful country. This was not only a time for good time, and it was a big experience. We met a lot of people from Scottish museums. We could see not only the museums, but also the secret places that you have, and to found more about the food, the culture. So I think this was a really amazing project. Of course, we learned very interesting things, and when I went back to Bulgaria, I presented these things to my colleagues and to the Ministry of Culture, of course. Because there is no sense only to visit something, I believe there must be something in result. So we were inspired by the Open Museum here from the Glasgow Resource Center, because the idea is really great to have one main object, presentation, and some artifacts into a suitcase. So this way, this is a small museum that can travel to around the world even. So we made interpretation of this open museum, and we call it Museum in Suitcase. Of course, it is my mom's student suitcase full of wonderful artifacts. We could create more than 10 different presentations about traditional rituals from the region, about the ritual bread in Bulgaria, about the Christian festivals, the old history of our place, my town. We travel with this suitcase in the schools in the town. The children are our target group, and they have fun, they listen with attention the presentations, they can stand 1 hour and listen what I want to tell, and after then they can open the suitcase and just see what we have in relation with the main object. So This is one activity that it is not only for children. We go to adults groups and present our suitcase, and it is very interesting, and it is also free. That is really important. They don't pay to have this suitcase. The last one is another inspiration for us from the same Glasgow Resource Center. We visited the museum store, and I was surprised that here you can just visit the hidden places of the museum. When I asked the guardian there who came in into your depot, he said this heritage belongs to Glasgow, so each person has the right to come in and to see what happens to the heritage of the community. So our complex is also open, not for visitors, but if you want to visit it, there is no problem to go inside. Maybe we will develop this idea. Last one, we have Scottish groups, thanks to this exchange with Arch and Devetaki Plato. These students from Britain had a great time this year by us not only working, but also so trying the taste of Bulgaria. I think we can learn a lot. So from you, and maybe you can take some practice from us. So the view from the airplane traveling to Scotland is my imagination for happiness, love, and I am very proud to be here. Thank you to Arch, Libby, and Beverly for the hospitality, and to all other people. You are really amazing. Thank you.